हम सबको जागृत करने के लिए और उमंग उत्साह को बढ़ाने के लिए बहुत अच्छे उम्दा कलाकार हमारे बीच में उपस्थित हैं। 2 ग्रैमी अवार्डीज एक साथ, ये हमारे पास हम सबका सौभाग्य है कि आज पंडित विश्व मोहन भट्ट जी पद्म भूषण से सम्मानित हमारे बीच में उपस्थित हैं, और मिस्टर रिकी केज वो भी हमारे बीच में उपस्थित हैं। कुछ समय में बहुत सुंदर सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रम, म्यूजिकल कॉन्सर्ट हम लाइव उनको देखेंगे परफॉर्म करते हुए। बहुत सुंदर जुगलबंदी उन दोनों के बीच में होगी। और जैसे कि इस कॉन्फ्रेंस का पर्पस है एनवायरनमेंट, कैसे समावेश हो, साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी ने क्या असर डाला है हमारे पर्यावरण पर, वो उसको अच्छे से हमें बताएंगे, समझाएंगे और अपने म्यूज़िक द्वारा दिखाएंगे और हमारे दिलों को छू जाएंगे। तो ये एक बहुत दिल को छू जाने वाली परफॉर्मेंस है जो हमारे बीच में लेकर के आ रहे हैं मिस्टर रिकी केज एंड पंडित विश्व मोहन भट्ट जी। हम आपका बहुत हार्दिक दिल से स्वागत करते हैं, अभिनंदन करते हैं, अभिवादन करते हैं।
We got to the actual ceremony. Nomination itself had not sunk in entirely. And I remember sitting down at the ceremony, you know, seeing all these celebrities and these musical legends who you've been admiring since your childhood. You know, and that's where the nervousness started actually kicking in. And both Walter and me became extremely nervous when you know, they actually announced and the nominees are
Rickie Cage and Walter Kelly.
And the Grammy goes to Winds of Samsara.
The name of the album was announced, you know, it was just a surreal experience getting up and walking up to the stage and actually making the acceptance speech.
I'd like to thank the Recording Academy and USA in general, because it's only in America that an Indian and a South African can receive the biggest music award. Asatoma Satgamaya Om Shanti 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 Om. Thank you. After I won the Grammy Award, I decided to dedicate my life and my music to my true passion of environmental consciousness.
Climate change is absolutely real. Climate change is human-induced. Climate change is affecting all of us, and our actions are affecting countries on the other side of the world.
We are not doing enough to protect rivers around the world, and I wanted to use the Ganga as an example.
Oh, Thank you. Namaste, everyone. Okay, now you have to be louder than that. I'm going to try something else. Right from the center of this hall to my far right, everybody shout after me. Om Shanti! From the center over here to my far left, Om Shanti! Now that was wonderful. Now, last year, I had the amazing opportunity and honor to perform at the headquarters of the Brahma Kumaris in Mount Abu. Yep. How many of you were there at that performance? Come on. Okay, a few of you. Now, this year in 2019, I'm absolutely blessed and I'm so honored and thrilled that I get to perform in front of the Brahma Kumaris again in this amazing auditorium. This is easily the most beautiful audience I've ever performed to, and you, the Brahma Kumaris, are the greatest movement to ever hit this planet. You guys, I'm going to tell you why. Because you guys promote gender equality, feminism, environmental consciousness, spirituality, responsibility, and everything that is good on this planet. A big round of applause to all of you. Come on. Now, I am Ricky Cage. I'm a musician. I'm an environmentalist. Two pillars that have pretty much dictated my entire life. And ever since I won the Grammy Award in 2015, I had decided to dedicate my life and my music entirely to creating environmental consciousness. Now, we as being Indians, it is absolutely within our culture, within our traditions, to be environmentalist and to be spiritual. Am I right? And that is what this concert is going to be all about. Now, in this same line, my next song is a song about water. None of us can live without water. Water is such an important natural resource that we are not treating with enough respect. We all know that civilizations have always been born on the banks of rivers. And when those rivers have dried up for whatever reasons, those civilizations have perished. So we made a song on the river Ganga. Because the river Ganga is the greatest river on this planet. She's a symbol of spirituality, of devotion, and of life itself. But what is extremely important is that the Ganga nourishes the lives of 1/10 of the world's population. I think the Ganga deserves a bigger round of applause. Maybe some screams. Come on. So this is my next song. It's a song where you can follow the Ganga's journey, her journey right from where she takes birth in the Himalayas to where she completes her journey into the Bay of Bengal. Here is Ganga.
Thank you.
many of you here, after listening to that song, fell in love with our river Ganga all over again? Come on. Yes, thank you so much. A big round of applause to all of you. Now I'm going to introduce everyone on stage once. On drums we have Arun Kumar. On vocals, Siddhartha. On flute and vocals, you just heard us sing and play the flute, Wari Jashri. On violin, Manoj George. On vocals, Alexis D'Souza. And on sitar, Sumarani. Now, all of us have heard of the term climate change. All of us have heard of climate change? So now, the thing about climate change is that we developing nations and developed nations, we pollute the atmosphere, and then what happens is that it's one atmosphere, so the whole world gets polluted, and sometimes countries which actually do not pollute the atmosphere are the ones that are suffering. I'll give you an example of the country known as Kiribati. Kiribati is a country in the South Pacific. It's in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. It's a very low-lying island and 21 islands, and they are going to be the first country in the world to go completely underwater. The country is going to disappear completely in the next 30 years because of climate change. Now what happens is that us developing nations, developed nations, Western countries, all these countries, all of our countries, we pollute the atmosphere through greenhouse gases, fossil fuels, emissions, and things like that. Because of this, the whole world is getting warmer. Now, when the whole world gets warmer, what is happening is that the polar ice caps, that is the North Pole and South Pole, is melting. Because of this, all the oceans, their levels are rising, the sea levels are rising, and because of this, coastlines and entire islands are going underwater. Now, as I was talking about this country, Kiribati, this particular country, they live within nature. They do not have any factories. They do not have any carbon emissions. They are a very traditional country, but at the same time, they are going to be the first country to go underwater for no fault of theirs, which showcases that this whole world is one big family, and whatever we do over here is affecting people on the other side of the world. So here is our next song. It is called Vishwa, and it is dedicated to the island nation of Kiribati. Here is Vishwa.
Science is very clear about climate change. Within the century, our entire nation will be underwater. As in some countries, you have a cyclone, a hurricane. Over time, the land remains there, the water recedes. In our case, it does not. It's a disaster that doesn't go away. Our reality is that we have communities who already have to relocate. They've left their villages. We have communities which are on the verge of doing the same thing. And so, for us, climate change is not something that's likely to happen in the future. It is happening, we are facing it.
See.
always referred to our situation as those countries on the front line, because when we fall, there'll be another front line, and that front line will keep moving back until those countries and those people who believe that they will not be affected will eventually be affected, and that is the reality we are facing. I think as human beings, we are being challenged. Should we do something about it? And I believe, yes, everybody has the responsibility to do it. Because the question that we continue to ask ourselves, what is to become of our children? How will they continue to live without that link with the land and the spirits therein?
Thank you. Now, if you can only imagine all those children that you saw in that video of this island nation of Kiribati, all these children are not going to have the opportunity to grow up in their own country, because in the next 30 years, their country is going to go completely underwater. So this is an example to show that what is happening with climate change is absolutely real, and our actions, whatever we do over here, is having disastrous consequences on people, our brothers and sisters, on the other side of the world. Now, moving on, when we think about the word coexistence, when we think about the word peace, when we think about the word harmony, what comes to our mind? Now, the only thing that seems to come to our mind nowadays when we think about coexistence, peace, and harmony is basically peace and harmony between Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, Christians, Jews, basically different parts of the human race. Because somewhere along our journey of being humans, we have completely forgotten that we are not the only living beings on this planet. Am I right? We are just one among millions and millions of living beings and living species on this planet. In fact, our own culture, our own traditions define peace and harmony and coexistence as living in absolute peace and harmony with every single entity in this planet, whether that entity is living or non-living. Am I right? You can be more enthusiastic. Am I right? So, we as Indians have really learned how to coexist with our nature, coexist with our forests and our wildlife. In fact, we pray to our forests, we revere and we pray to our wildlife, and especially the elephant. Who over here loves the elephant? Come on! But because of growing human population, because of growing human greed, there is an issue. We are fighting with elephants, we are taking away their lands. And sometimes when we take away their lands, then what our government and what our forest department is forced to do is to capture these elephants and relocate them to another area. Because we're capturing their lands, so we capture these elephants and we relocate them to another area. Now, it seems like a very good solution because you're not killing the elephant, you're only capturing the elephant and relocating them. But this itself is a very, very painful procedure, not just for the elephants, but for all the humans involved. Our next song is a dedication to the elephant. It's a dedication to coexistence, a dedication to living in peace and harmony with all species on this planet. Here is our next song. It's called Love Divine.
Thank you.
Translated to English means the world is one family. Okay, the world is one family. It's a Sanskrit phrase when translated to English. I'm going to count to three and I want all of you all to shout out that Sanskrit phrase at the top of your voice so loud. One, two, three. Why are you all really sleepy? Let's try it again. One, two, three. Doesn't that feel nice? Now, I'm going to ask you a couple of more questions. Now, at the count of three, I want all of you to shout out your first name. Your first name, I want you to shout out when I count to three. As loud as you can. Come on. One, two, three. Oh, good to know all of you. Thank you. Now, when I count to three, I want all of you to shout out the name of the village or town that you grew up in or you were born in. So the name of the village or the city or the town that you were born in, please shout it out when I count to three. One, two, three. Oh, very nice. Did you all get all of that? Okay, now I'm gonna count to three and I want all of you to name the planet that we live on. Okay, I want all of you to name the planet that we live on. One, two, three. Wasn't that loud and clear? All of us are part of one family. All of us have a common future, and we need to work towards that common future. Here is our next song, written by Alexis D'Souza, standing right in front of me. In fact, she wrote the last two songs too. A big round of applause for her. Here is One Family.
We share a home.
Thank you so much. Now, there is a beautiful verse in the Yajurveda which talks about the five elements and all these five elements being protected by Lord Shiva. Any of you have heard of who Lord Shiva is? Wow, nobody? Any of you have heard of who Lord Shiva is? So, each element is protected by Lord Shiva and each element gives rise to another element, as all of us know. Everything started off with space. Space gave rise to wind. Wind gave rise to fire. Fire gave rise to water. Water gave rise to the earth, and the earth gave rise to all life forms. Now, we as humans are nothing without these five elements. Can any of you live without water? Can any of you live without breathing air? Can any of you live without food and vegetation? So basically, Lord Shiva, being the protector of these five elements, is considered to be the savior of us all. And the only way for us to reach Lord Shiva is through sadhana and meditation, and most importantly, protecting these five elements and protecting our environment. Am I right? Here is our next song. It's called Elements.
Yetasmadva Yetasmadatmana Akasha Sambhutah
I have the amazing, amazing honor to introduce one of my, I mean, my most biggest childhood hero, Pandit Vishwamohan Bhat, Grammy Award winner, Padma Bhushan winner. He's been really gracious to come and join us today. He flew in all the way from Calcutta. He's got another concert tonight, but even then, he agreed to come and join us. I think he deserves some shouts. Come on. Thank you, sir. Now, for this next song is going to be a Jugalbandi piece. It's going to be an improvisational piece. All of us musicians are going to have fun over here. Because as I say at every one of my concerts, that I only work with musicians and people who are better than me. And today, everyone over here is a great example of that. A big round of applause to everyone on stage. And this particular piece has been composed by this amazing violin player who is on my right, Manoj George. A big round of applause for him too. So we'll just take a second. Okay, here we go. Manoj, take it over.
gamapane gane sane ne ne ba ne ne ma 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 ga ma ga ga sa ne sa ga ma ba ga ma ba ne ne ba ma ba ma ga ma ba ne sa ga
You want to join with me? Okay. I can't hear you.
Thank you.
Wow! Okay, everyone! My favorite drummer and percussionist in the whole world, Arun Kumar! My favorite Hindustani classical vocalist in the whole world, Siddhartha! My favorite flute player in the whole world, Vari Jashri! My favorite violinist in the whole world, give him a big round of applause, Manoj! My favorite sitarist in the whole world, Sumarani! And the living legend, the amazing Pandit Vishwamohan Bhatt! Now next up is a song about the world coming together, celebrating our differences, celebrating our diversity, celebrating our biodiversity, celebrating all that who we are, celebrating a brighter and a more beautiful future for everyone around us and everything. Here is our next song. It's called One Song. Everyone, please stand up for this. Come on. Everyone.
Reach out, let us join hands and sing this one song.
Thank you. And now to conclude, I wanted to say that all of us need to be global citizens to combat the effects of climate change and of environmental disasters. But at the same time, as long as we are global citizens, we also need to be patriotic Indians. Am I right? How many? Are there any patriotic Indians over here? So I played this version of our national anthem in the morning, but right now I want to play this version again with Pandit Vishwamohan Bhatt playing it. Here is our national anthem dedicated to the true citizens of India, the forests and wildlife, the true inhabitants of India, because they have shaped our country. They make our country what it is. They make our country beautiful. Here is the Indian national anthem dedicated to the natural world of India. Great rest of the evening. All my best. Brahma Kumaris are awesome. Thank you.
Adarniya Mrityunjay Bhai, hamare bahut hi sundar kalakaron ka itna sundar pradarshan kiya. Zordar taaliyon dwara inka abhinandan karenge.